माननीय व्यासपीठ आणि मित्रांनो, मला निरोप आला होता की आपण हिंदी मध्ये बोला आणि आता मला कळलं की तुमचं लेक्चर शेवटचं आहे, तुम्ही किती वेळ घ्या. आय होप इट नॉट थेट फॉर यू, नो अश्युअरन्स फॉर मी. आय जॉईन द ग्रँड मेडिकल कॉलेज इन 1948 and became a surgeon in 1959. I am going to share with you my experiences of last 60 years. Next, patient-doctor relationship is unique in the whole world. It involves science, technology. With technology, ethics must come in, psychology, sociology, and finances. This was an image of a doctor in the society. This is a great painting. This is not a photograph by Sir Luke Fields, who was a well-known artist in the world. And when Tate started his gallery, he told St. Fields to draw a painting of social importance. And Luke Fields was such a remarkable man. He believed in the power of images, even not in films or drama, but even in paintings. And he chose as his topic, sorry, I don't know what he's capable of. Wait a minute. These new guys, I can't work for you. I don't know where not to touch. Sir Luke Fields took as his key painting his own son who died at a young age. Great trade in his life. And St. Lucius wanted to keep the image of the doctor who treated his son till he died in this form of his painting. This is a world famous painting. Many stamps have been made. An American Medical Association in 1949 printed 65,000 posters of this painting. The doctors are good human beings. I don't know why the doctors are always on the defensive. Doctors are good human beings, and in the past he was a friend, philosopher and guide. Now he has become a technician. What was the image? I know Sushruta Samhita, 2,500 years back, has written well. He should be a man of wide learning, of wide practical experience, skillful, pure, practice of hands, self-control, fully equipped with the art of healing, in full possession of his faculties, conversant with the normal course of nature, able to take prompt appropriate decisions. He is known as a savior of life and destroyer of disease. 2,500 years back, and the things have not changed. This one I got from a medical journal in 1980 when I went to America. I see what the American people want them, highly qualified who attend conferences, more preferable we invited to give lectures, easily available for appointments, should not get angry on phone, spend enough time for consultations, non-smoker, lovely asa kaam hai, no affairs in personal life, because doctor is the only man who is allowed to enter a bedroom. And preferably a Sunday church goer. आता विचार करा अमेरिका देशामध्ये चर्च मध्ये जाणं मोठं चांगला असतो असा तर सर्व असतो आहे. तर विचार करा की दी अमाउंट ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेशन दॅट पीपल आर फ्रॉम अस, बट वी मस्ट मे नॉट रीच द प्लेस, वी मस्ट ट्राय टू नो व्हॉट दे एक्सपेक्ट ऑफ अस. टिल a long time, In life, everything is a ritual. Meeting a girl or a boy for the first time is a ritual. Marriage is a ritual. Getting degree is a ritual. And even funeral is a ritual. It marks something important in life. So what was the thing about time? It was an era of clinical diagnosis. When a patient comes to you, look at him, ask a history, examine him, and then come to some decision. And as somebody said very rightly, in acute abdominal pain, I can tell you one thing, in 8 out of 10 cases, we can be almost correct without the peripheral nerve investigations. This is what I have done throughout my life, which I have taught to many students as well. And then we treat them. But this went on from 1950 to 1990. And then came the tsunami of investigations. And when a patient, as Pratapra Pawar said, I think, when he comes to a hospital, he is taken on a conducted tour of various investigative departments. And the patient-doctor contact has plummeted down. I'll give a simple example. A young lady, 2 years after marriage, consulted a gynecologist for lower abdominal pain. Very good. Ultrasound was done without taking any history. Ultrasound showed, ovarian cyst, it has to come out. We do with laparoscopy, hardly a few hours stay in the hospital, we can go for work on the third day, simple job. Done, cyst was removed, showed to the patient, very happy. The symptoms continued. And within 15 days, she came to us, and the history was classical intestinal obstruction, means like a roadblock. In roadblock, horns are playing, there's a lot of traffic jam. In intestine, for what happens? There's a tremendous noise in the sound. Gar, 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 gar. You put a stethoscope, gar, 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 the sound goes on. They can't pass gases down. They can't bring anything out. Not one question was asked. We have told schools for a long time, listen to a patient who is giving you a diagnosis. And the picture was so clear. Dr. Pota, itka dukha hai sir. Normal की मायी झोपड़ना जाग रही है ची वो उल्टी अलग बर्बादी सर nothing was asked because ultrasound gives an instant diagnosis and we are keen for instant coffee, instant food, instant marriages and instant divorces. This is an era of something to happen all the time very fast. Technology has a prestige, of course it has a prestige, but we are becoming addicted to instant information through touch screen. We forgot to touch the patients. That's a sad thing. And now it's an era of remote control medicine, not only in life, but also in this area, remote control medicine. And here's a very good thing. I like to see this thing. Here on a marriage day, they're planning a honeymoon. Here is a breakfast nursing school in Tokyo. And here is a young baby. She will not take milk unless she is given a computer to work on. These are not jokes. My friend's daughter in Ahmedabad does not take milk unless she is given a smartphone to work on. This is sad, but we must keep in mind that the way things should are going or not to go. What is the importance of touch? I think touch is a remarkable thing that we have, which people do not realize. Paul Brand was a well-known orthopedic surgeon, English surgeon, who was settled in Vellore. One day he saw a patient with leprosy, with his fingers completely gone. Paul Brand examined him, saw all these things, he says, "Don't worry, we'll be able to help you. Your hand will come back to a lot of work and do." and when he was going to the hall for admission with the nurse, he suddenly stopped, sat down and started crying. Why? He says, for many years, nobody had touched me. Leprosy. He says, even my own relations had not touched me. He says, he was not happy because something can be done. He says, ask me my uncle, heart lavela. We have not known the power of a human touch in life. In my own case, I'm a man who came with ulcerative colitis. 15 to 18 bloody stools every day. He traveled 500 miles to come to my consulting room. Was he still lamb kala to sahab tumcha na aikun alo ami. Anyhow, I had a regular ritual even now. I had taken history, and a ritual is not to show up, wrong impression. Ritual is something which is essential for human society to live well. I got some 2-3 tests done. He came to me, and what he told me is very important now. He said, Doctor, you have to ask me if you have a car, but you have to ask me if you have a hand on shant hand. And from that day, for the next 3 days, he passed only 4 to 5 bloody stools a day. From 15, he came to 5. Why? I only had touched him. From middle birth, I feel sad. People don't know what a human touch can do, which I have so blessed with it. And this is what must be told. I have been a student, I have been a teacher, I have taught by many schools all over. Please talk to your patients. Please look into their eyes. Touch them. And many people will get well in spite of drugs. In America, and one more thing, please tell me when I should stop. It was my ritual that before anesthesia, I must see my patient first and then before anesthesia. Why? In the operating theater, the patient is completely terrified, everybody with a mask on, instruments are there, and he does not know anybody. There were strict instructions that unless I come and talk with the patient, don't give an anesthesia. In England, I did the same thing. And they said, Doctor, you have come now. Now we are at ease. In England, one man told me, which is difficult to believe, Doctor, even if I die in your hands, I'll be all right. No, tell me, this is not something, an exaggeration. But the human stories are so great, which literally people do not even know, but they are all fashion life. I am willing to die at your hand because it's so nice to meet you. I think the man in a doctor is far more important than the man with his instruments in his hands. In America, there are notes now. Have you hugged your child? Ka? Tar don pidyamala antar vadya mula ta kai kele paise? I ask my patient, have you touched your patient? What is technology? Ashwaha jivanata varya pari gatiti nahi lagamahati rikibita payanahi. Kusumadra was my great friend. These small poems convey a lot. Now is a health marketing. When just up here, I can tell one thing. In law, you are innocent till proved guilty. Sorry, I think I touched somewhere else. I'm not used to these things in life, because I made all my slides on my own. In law, you are innocent till you prove guilty. But in the era of health marketing, everybody is sick and they prove otherwise by thorough investigation. Formerly, doctors gave comforts. Now doctors, well, to be on the safe side, let's not take any chance, do the investigation. Don't take a chance. They don't realize. We start taking a chance when we are born, and we can't take a chance after we die. It means for the whole of your life, you can be investigated, and that was happening. And this is what I see every day now. There is a disease called functional bowel disturbances, where every organ or appendage is something wrong with them. Acidity, heartburn, poor appetite, gas, gas, the bimari, pain in the back, pain in the chest, lack of energy, constipation, urinary problem, fibromyalgia, menstrual disturbances, poor sense desire. And then what happens? For every symptom, there are symptoms, there are investigations. And then you can go round and round, and when the patient does not feel better, he changes his doctor. And doctor says, now let's start again. This is a sad thing. And the largest amount of money which is spent in the world today on health services is on investigating a person who has no disease. We are also charged, what are we about unindicated operations? Unindicated operations have been going on for a long time. Even America in 1928, they had done a survey of unindicated appendicectomies. In 1971, I have prepared literature. I go to my patients to read. As I ask them these questions to people, what is wrong with me? Is operation necessary? What is likely to happen if I don't get the operation done? What do we do if my symptoms are not relieved after surgery? This is the most important question. Huh? What do we do if my symptoms are not relieved after surgery? Because every week I see patients, operation done, symptoms continue. Will you do the pathological examination of the part that is removed from me? I want those slides from my records. And lastly, I want to have a full report of the treatment. If you do like this, I tell you, 70% of unindicated operation will come down. I am telling you this, Dr. Pawar, to instead of blaming the doctors, make a society more informed. A pratna vichara, and here's a pratna vichara le, the unindicated operation will go down. So educate the society, don't try to moralize doctors. Let the society be more educated. And we are not trusting doctors, but tell them what should be done, because it's easy to criticize, it's difficult to say what can be done. There was a visionary in year 1900. His name was Codman, and he said a very nice thing. Every hospital must keep a record of the treatment given to a patient, what was the outcome, and follow for 5 years. And with this statement, everybody in the hospital went against him. He was removed from the imaginary hospital. But unfortunately, had America listened to him, that his accountability, doctor ne kya karta hai, kitni baar baal kya baatte aata hai, if they would have followed their advice, this has come to America now. The richest country in the world, unhappy patients, unhappy doctors, rising costs, rising expectations. 43 million people have no insurance cover. And a country which is so health conscious, 40% people are now obese, and then obesity work. Come on, laparoscopy kar denge. You create a problem and you solve them. You create a solve them. I think a good doctor is one who sees to how to prevent the disease. What do I tell people? Our human body is a miracle. I give lectures all over. Our heart beats 72 times a minute. At night it does not stop, it just rate comes down. We pump 7,000 liters of blood every day, beats 2.5 million times in one lifetime, pumps 180 million liters of blood. Our lungs, we breathe 40 to 18 times a minute, 24,000 times per day. 42 crores in whole lifetime, and the same true with liver, kidney, intestines. Our body is so good, why do you keep carrying the chatin dukte thorse? But examine the patient first, and ask you dukte mukte sunta ka. Tell them our body is good, our body is quite strong. Okay. I'll tell them something more interesting thing, my own thing here. Here was a lady at the age of 38, operated for acute appendix in 1978. He developed a fistula in the intestine, operated twice, it again came out, and she was referred to me after 14 days with the whole skin completely burnt, all the veins completely blocked. She had not taken anything by mouth, and she had lost 10 kilos of weight. And this came to me, and in those days, we did not have TPN. We did not have new needles. So what did we do? We removed the tube from the stomach to sarva khana shuru karata. Why? If the intestinal hole, at least part of the food that you eat can still be absorbed. And the natural food is far better than total parenteral nutrition costing 5,000 rupees per day with a chance of infection. Eat the normal food well. And what I did was, her husband and her three children were made to sit with her side. Everybody has a 6-hour duty. And remember one thing, patients' relations do far better work than a nurse or a doctor. This is so common. And what did we do? We said that every drop of juice that comes out, it should be sucked out so that it will not touch the skin. Point number two, no dressing. If you put a dressing, the whole thing gets completely sodden, and eat what you want. She ultimately started eating 24 vital eggs of the day. And you can see here now, within next 3 weeks, the entire wound healed. This is what nature we have. Nature has the power to heal itself so well. And you see here the amount of things that she got well. And how much was the expense? 24 white eggs of the day. I tell this because to tell people not what I have done. Of course, I have showed this picture to all parts of India and they can't believe it can be true. I heard a lecture in London in 1958 by a very well-known physician. He gave a nice talk about recent advances in medicine. But in the end, he said very nicely. He said, a young man comes and asks me, doctor, I want to lead a long and healthy life. What should I do? He says, keep away from tobacco. Do not get fat. Take daily exercise. Eat plenty of vegetables and fruits and lead a meaningful life. Manje, artha purna je, artha manje, ha artha nahi. Something useful to society. You will live a long and healthy life without doctors and medicines. What is told in 1958 still stands true and will still remain true for 1 million years at least. Can I take 5 minutes more? It's coming to the end. I tell you the unbelievable expectation from patients that nobody can ever die. With modern medicine, you can cure all things in life. In Bern in near 2000, Professor Buchler, who is a world-renowned surgeon whom I introduced to India, I was taking a round with him. And my patient in the room was getting angry with him. I know that he was upset. So I asked Professor Bhikula, I said, sir, what's wrong? He said, Professor Srikhande, this patient was expected to go after liver transplant after 15 days. He stayed extended for 4 days. He upset with me. He said, this man has destroyed his liver by drinking beer. We have worked for 10 hours to do a liver transplant. He is almost well, but he's fighting with me. Why will you not stay me in time? Ungrateful patients. In 1984, I had done operation on a man, fat man, uncontrolled diabetic, with a personal gallbladder, taken the consent, and the operation, we just removed the pus. And he died of multiple organ failure. They started throwing things in the wall. So, pehle kyun nahi kiya, pehle kyun kiya operation? He said, when the patient was dying, you were not there. My patient, my doctor will be there when he dies. Doctor will be there when he operates. Can anything be done? What was fair? One lady doctor's comment was same type. Dr. Srikhande, you will realize what it is when your father will die. Here the educated girl tells me, whose father I operated for a very bad gallbladder pus inside, doctor, you realize what are my thoughts just now? I said, a patient post-mortem must be done. And lastly, in 1956, one man came here, I think most of the underworld, acute appendix, with all people that come there, and I was doing the operation, let's do the operation, on three conditions, or two conditions, patient must not die, and patient must not have the same problem again. Now see one thing, here is a ruffian from Mumbai. Here is a 90-year-old woman who died after intestinal obstruction. Her daughter in America wanted to sue me. Can you believe it? Her father had operated here in 94, he was well. So you see here, sorry, I think I must know what I should not touch. So you see here, a man with an underworld, a highly educated woman whose father had operated. Here is a lady doctor, here is a man who has a big business in Uttar Pradesh. See, human beings, when something goes wrong, we behave the same way. Plastic cells have been shot dead. Something interesting, not interesting, something to keep in mind. Here was a man who killed his surgeon because the result of his nose was not good. In 2014, last year a very well-known surgeon in Russia was shot dead because the man had not got the operation of a ear, and the ear was not looking well. And here was a very good plastic surgeon was killed by a patient who operated for breast cancer, and again the cosmetic surgery was done. He said, but it is not a good job. Three surgeons were shot dead. Now, few slides. On a holy day, I saw when India, when Maharashtra was suffering from drought, school children from a good school throwing water. Among these school children will be doctors of tomorrow, judges of tomorrow, principals of tomorrow, Rajkandilo Vinayak, and now this is a medical college, private limited. The limited here refers to the ability and competence of the student authority. This has been shown by our good doctor, who is a good cartoonist. Why do I show these things? I am worried. This is a future of tomorrow. I love poetry. I think most of poets will be my friend. Baba Bhurto was my friend. Swarga nako, surga loka nako, maza loba sahaya loka hawa. Trupti nako, maza mukti nako, yetula hashani shoka hawa. Pati vyata sa vasa hawa, pari divyasa avyasa hawa. Shastra sa avyasa hawa, pari manan vyasa dhyasa hawa. I tell you, my thoughts at my age, I am now 85. I am a contented man. I am a happy man. Cheated nobody in my life. So I think I like the poem because it's so applicable to me in my own life. And what did I do? I never addressed a patient by cot number. I case the case of cancer rectum. No, he has a name. I use a screen to maintain a patient's dignity. You have no idea? We doctors, we medical students, they strip the patient open, breast daka, heka, teka. They are human beings. I got for an examination in South India. I was shocked to see in a big hall, men and women, they removed their clothes and were examining. I say, why do you do like this? Sir, they never complain. I tell them that poor people, their only language is by silence. They suffer, we are not bothered about them. Some doctors do psychological bombing on patients. I taught my students that when I enter a war, 36 pair of eyes are eagerly waiting for my smile and human touch. And this is what I taught my students for the last 50 years. Touch your patients, be in good mood. Don't go with a casual face. be happy, give them hopes in life. And I'm very happy to tell you that many of my students are doing outstanding work. I'm happy to tell you, Mr. Pawar Sahib, the first liver transplant was done 3 months back by my student here. Yesterday she did a kidney transplant here. This is what one man can do. Now I'm told she had done 2 liver transplants and 10 kidney transplants. The other students yesterday had to do a liver transplant here. My student has done now 1500 open heart surgery from the place which I come. You know, I think the main thing is I have made people big in life. I didn't want to become big on my own. I took people to become high in life. So I had a unique honor to open the Print of India because not because I had done the operation, but remember one thing, I did the operation by a method which was used 100 years back, but which falls into disrepute. I could do the operation under local anesthesia, and it was told in America and India it cannot be done. So it's not that I'm needing to show what I've done, but all old things are not bad, and all old is not good. Significance of existence. This slide has a big ovation end. What will matter is every act of integrity, compassion, courage, creativity, service that enrich, empower, and inspire others to follow an example. And this is what we all teachers must do in life. I have written a book at the age of 78 because I had no time to write earlier, and I can't believe I got 6 literary awards. I can't believe it can't be true, but it is true. I asked, last one slide. I asked one English professor from America, as a Malay Pustar Red Hase, tell me what I should do. And Kaka, to our Pustar Red Hase, open a yaka. So I did cool Vasan Kelapaji, and roll after Basun the Hilata, but the book may come. Which is readable. I don't believe in experts at times. I say, I can't read many books, I can't read fast. I can't sit for 8 hours a day for 5 years, it's impossible for me. And so I wrote a book, and I think she proved wrong. But I wrote a letter, Dr. Amcha Mulala, Igraji, Bhakta Samastha, Marathi Yetna, I said, not California, but I go. छात्र लिखते सर पर बड़ा सर गंदा नहीं है इग्नोर में पुस्तक लिया सो आई रोट अ बुक हियर रिफ्लेक्शंस ऑफ अ सर्जन एंड एंड माय टॉक बाय सेइंग वन थिंग आर्थर मिलर ग्रेट प्ले राइट हस्बैंड ऑफ कौन अपनी ही एक्ट्रेस को कभी सुसाइड हाँ बेल मंगलो ही हैज रिटन अ गुड स्टेटमेंट With an exception of a doctor saving a life, writing a worthy book is one of the most rewarding activities in life. I felt I had done both the jobs. This is what I tell you. All doctors are not good, all doctors are not bad. I think in society, in every walk of life, there are good individuals. And we as human beings say, look at good things in life. Be grateful to your life. Be grateful to science. And the society will
live.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I think for his lifetime work, he deserves a standing ovation by all of us.